Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Crowmoore. Welcome back to This is the Cutscene 2, a game that is 80% cutscenes and another 20% of me failing miserably. Last time we did another tactical mission and everybody died. So, now I'm wondering if it is actually possible to finish this game when we are doing so horribly bad. I guess we'll see. I guess the police force is not getting any better because all of our good guys are dead or dying in an instant you put them out on a mission. So, well, I'm not sure what to do here, but to just carry on. Oh, Jesus Christ. This is horrible. Okay, let's begin. We have Birch 3. Saying, Mr. Nash, Pierce's widow is stopping cops as they come to the station and telling them all this stuff about corruption and some kind of investigation that's coming. She says it's in all our interests to get you out in the open. I feel sorry for her, of course. Pierce was a good cop and a good father. A death of somebody like that, it drove the poor woman crazy. I hope the guys see she's just really upset and no one takes the stuff she's saying seriously. Oh, fuck. Mustard. Oh, shit, wall of text. Nash, I was up late yesterday after the shift and found Donna Ferry hard at work. The poor woman went through the whole station, cleaned stuff out that hasn't been touched for years. Of course, I helped her lift the heavy stuff and we talked until midnight without stopping. I couldn't take my eyes off her. She's such a beautiful and practical woman and she respects our work. You know how folks normally treat cops around here. I've always dreamed of a woman like this, and I decided that old age wasn't going to stand in my way. I took destiny in my hands last night and proposed on the spot. And she agreed, can you imagine? So I'm going to retire. I want to live out the rest of my days living in a quiet family life, not dodging bullets. And I won't be idle. She's got her children that I'll be helping with, so I'll still have plenty to do. I won't be bored with retirement. Oh yeah, and I almost forgot. All the guys at the station appreciated that you are trying to make their lives cleaner and more comfortable. Okay, so we lost the chauvinist Mustard. Oh, Baroka, what's up? Mr. Nash, today's the funeral for Mikola Misika. I want to go honor the memory of a good cop. Oh, nope. Nope. No. Oh, Jesus Christ. Jesus fucking Christ. We only have 6 people. What would have happened if I let everyone go to the funeral? I don't know. Oh, Jesus Christ. This is not going well. Auto assign. Let's start the day. Jesus fucking Christ. No, we do not have anyone for these investigations. No. Okay, let's do a cutscene. Oh! No cutscenes. Fry's payment. You have to pay Fry 20,000 every week if you want the feds to stay away from Sharpwood. The first payment is the day after tomorrow. Start saving. What? Are we going to... Okay, from time to time, Sharpwood residents may come to you with personal requests. Of course, this work is off the books. But sometimes assignments like this can earn some extra money. But I don't wanna be a corrupted cop. What's this? Sycamore Street. I'm trying to get my hands on a collection of dusty old coins that Evelyn Gussman is holding on to, but the old lady rejected several generous offers. She says that the coins are the only thing that she has left from her dead husband, which means they are priceless for her. Once she follows her husband into the grave, the coins will go to probate and I won't get another chance to buy them again. So I want to get them some other way. Send one of your people to her to tell her the coins are connected to a federal investigation and the state might need to confiscate them. That'll definitely get her to sell them. It's not like I'm going to rip off the old lonely bag. I'll give her a fair price and I'll pay you for your help too. No. Do I have to? I don't wanna be corrupt. What? Is this like something I have to do? I want to keep my nose clean. Oh, for fuck, let's send the drunk. I really don't want to be corrupt. It's a shame if the game forces me. Oh yeah. Dead. Oh no. Well, when you think about it, we lost a lot of people. Oh, we have a hostage situation. We lost a lot of people, but at least I could keep my like nose clean and be uncorrupt. We could be honorable. Oh, Jesus Christ. Maybe if the feds come and take Geralt away, maybe that's just justice. Okay, Bank of Sharpwood. A bank employee took his boss hostage for failing to give him a raise. Do we need a sniper? Oh, no, I don't think so. But we are going to send in Glimsy. And who else? Birch, maybe? Yes, just enough. So, I think Sharpwood is... What's this? Nash, I'm not a great liar, but the old woman nearly had a heart attack when I told her a story about the feds, some serial killers and a terrible curse. What? I don't wanna take any blood money. God damn it. But yeah, we are not doing so hot. I think Sharpwood is going to keep being this cesspool of criminal activity in the future as well, because we just cannot clean it up. Okay, old church. A group of atheists are noisily demanding that the church shut down. 700? Oh. Okay, so that's everyone. Oh shit. Okay, we are at the hostage situation. A young guy in a shirt and tie is holding a pair of scissors at his boss's throat. I deserve a raise more than anyone else here. Are we stealthy? Birch is somewhat stealthy. So we can sneak up, we can tell the man that no one gets a raise through violence, or we can shoot in the air. Let's be diplomatic here. You're right, I just need to work even harder and then I'll definitely be appreciated. He then puts the scissors on the floor and surrender to the police. I don't think you'll be working there anymore, mate. Okay, good job, Birch. You will be getting some more negotiation skills. We got the freeze buddy perk. Before raising the alarm, the policeman can take an offender on the fly and immobilize him for one turn. Okay. The drunk is back. But yeah, I don't think that if we get another tactical mission, I don't want to send anybody there. Because everyone is just going to die there. Oh shit. Okay, religion is nigh, filled with monsters. A religion is night, not nigh. Filled with monsters, the protesters are chanting. At the front of the crowd is a woman in horn-rimmed glasses carrying The Origin of Species by Charles Darwin. Alright. Calm down the crowd, shoot into the air. God is light, there's no darkness in him. Aronovich. Could maybe calm down the crowd. Let's see what happens.
522 complete.
Oh shit. I didn't believe it was going to work, but excellent. The cop manages to calm down the crowd. The rally's leader agrees to go to the station for further discussion. Excellent. And Galilahi will be getting some stealth. Shadow perk. A policeman can spend one action and move right in front of the enemy without them even noticing. Yeah, I think... Policeman hides better behind small cover. Yeah, I think what we did wrong apart from all the other things we did wrong, but was the thing that we didn't have many stealth guys. So we immediately, in those tactical missions, we were revealed and had to shoot out everyone. So, and because we suck at shooting, it seems, and we didn't know how to use the sniper, everyone just died. Okay, there's a rape. Mr. Roger Linnington's gas station. A girl went to refuel her car, but forgot her purse at home. When the gas station attendant learned that she didn't have any money, he demanded that the girl suck him for every gallon. Okay. That's not cool, man. This is not enough, so we need to send our top guys. Oh, I can't wait until Flower Potts gets out of the hospital. Flower Potts will survive. The gas station attendant has the girl's hands tied with a hose, and he's forcing her to her knees. He's threatening her as he unbuttons his pants. Bitch, you move a muscle and I'll pour gasoline down your throat and set you on fire. Okay, this guy's balanced. Stab the rapist with a big knife. Sneak up on the rapist. Shoot the rapist with a taser. Okay, Glimsy will shoot the rapist. Boop. 541 complete. Yes! The girl was not physically hurt. See, we can do actually some good here. If we just stay away from the tactical missions, that is. Okay. Shooting. Lucky shot. If the policeman misses, he fires off another shot quickly with a slightly lowered accuracy. Yeah, the one thing I was thinking that are those tactical missions mandatory? Or did I just went there and shot myself in the leg because I went there too early? Or it could be that I just suck so bad. Tonight they buried Kevin Penkin. He was bit farewell by a drunken gravedigger and a mongrel dog. Oh shit, Penkin. Where's your band, mate? Or was there ever any band? Bus stop. A drunk laborer is extorting fare money from people who are waiting the bus. Waiting for the bus. Okay. Drunk can talk to a drunk. And oh, was Galilahi the kind of person who don't want to go with drunks? Oh, she went there. Hey, actually, I just noticed. These are all loyal people. They are all wearing hats, so that means they are loyal and they are not those sucky dudes that won't do what I say. A short, fat laborer with a large head is pulling at the purse of a tall girl. Let's see if you don't have any cash, you bitch. Use a baton. Restrain the workman. Hey, buddy, calm down or you'll be keeping your balls in a purse. We don't have much strength, so baton is maybe out of the question. But then again, then might be the restraining also. Okay, Miradian will... Oh, yeah. Galilahi would have the baton, but... Yeah, Miradian will restrain the workman. The cop tried to restrain the drunken laborer, but he headbutted him in the face. The cop's nose starts gushing blood. A bus drives up, and the criminal snatches the girl's handbag and runs onto the bus, ordering the driver to pull away. Oh, fuck! Rush to the doors of the bus, shoot into the air, shoot out the bus's tire. Galilahi has some speed, so maybe she could rush to the bus. Oh, no! Oh, we did get in. The cop manages to get inside the bus before the doors close. The drunken laborer is laying on the seat at the end of the bus. Wow, talking is hard. Rummaging through the stolen handbag. Order the laborer to surrender. Silently take aim at the laborer. Shoot the laborer with a taser. Silently take aim. I don't think we can order him to surrender. We don't have any negotiation skill. So let's... We don't also have any shooting skill. But... let's shoot him with the taser. Boom! Yes! He'll get a free ride, alright. To the police station. That's something like straight out of CSI Miami. We haven't failed this episode. So, that's something. Injury. Muradian, 2 days in the hospital for getting bumped in the nose. Oh, fuck. What's this? Attempted murder. A guy was trying to pick up a girl on the street. When she blew him off, he followed her back to her house, made a Molotov's cocktail and threw it through her window. What the what? Okay, so things escalated. Glimsy and Galilai. Oh, not quite enough. So, Borodka. Go handle things. Oh, hell. I think we are... I don't know, but I would guess that this game has multiple endings. And I think we are not going to get the happy one. Oh, shit. Oh, how can I suck so bad at this? So, like... I mean... Is it, like, not balanced? The tactical mission stuff? Or do I just suck? If you have played this game, did you have any problems with them? Although I suck at most of the games I play, so that might be the case. We are at the attempted murder scene. Flames are coiling out the broken window of the first floor. Outside, there's a man with his hands on his hip, admiring his handiwork. We can sneak up on the suspect, we can order him to surrender, or we can shoot him with the laser. Laser. Fucking taser. Oh shit, this almost turned into a sci-fi game. Okay, so who has the taser? Both guys have it. And Glimpse is good at shooting. Okay, shoot him. What? Is that not the taser? Okay. Then we will be ordering him to surrender. Or... Oh shit. We don't have any stealth. Yeah. Let's order him. The suspect obeyed the cop and surrendered. Meanwhile, a woman's cry can be heard through the flaming window. The front door is covered in flames. Rush into the building, wait for the fire truck, circle around the building. Okay. Is this a... Oh, actually. Well, I think this might end up in a tragedy, so maybe we'll be sending Borodka there. He could circle around the building to find another way inside.
526 complete.
Yes! She inhaled some smoke, but she'll be alright. Oh, excellent. I was pretty sure that Borodka was a gunner. Negotiate? No. He has strength, so... I think speed would also be good. Yeah, get those perks. The wedding funeral. What's this? From Paige Salazar. My happiest day became a nightmare. Today I got married and became a widow. Oh, fuck. Yes, my Karim wasn't young, but he was a real man and a retired cop. We were celebrating our wedding, and everything was magical until it was time for the traditional dance. Karim and I had fun whirling in the center of the room when suddenly his heart seized up. He fell to the floor, and a minute later he wasn't breathing. He died in my arms. But in his life, Karim was a cheerful man, and he wouldn't want all this wonderful festive food and drink to be wasted. He told me a lot about his days working for the police, about how there was hardly ever a chance to get a break from the hard work. And then I started thinking he'd have loved you guys to help yourself to our table. Please come take everything back to the station, eat your fill and take a rest from your troubles. But most of all, take that stuff away. I don't think I can even look at the wedding cake without breaking into tears. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. I was afraid that this was some kind of letter from a spouse of one of our lost officers, and that it was going to be like shaming us for what we did. But okay, we got some food.
5-11 in progress.
We have a hit and run at the city center. Two drunk guys racing their motorcycles and accidentally hit an invalid who was slowly crossed the road. Weird wording there. I know I'm not a native English speaker, but let's see this. Two drunk guys racing their motorcycles and accidentally. So were racing their motorcycles and accidentally hit an invalid who was slowly crossing the road. Aha, Crowmoore police. One of the motorcycles turned over and its rider was killed. The other rider is attempting to evade arrest. Okay. So, 5:25. Aronovich Galilei. Go, my beauties. We are going to have a problem next day because we lost a drunk. Galilahi needs some rest. So that leaves us only 4 people. Oh, fuck. Patrol car catches up with the motorcycle. Its rider is a bald-headed man wearing riding goggles. Leap onto the motorcycle, turn on the siren, order him to stop. Okay. I think Aronovich can order him to stop.
5-11 complete.
Yes! I think this might be... let's give him some negotiation. First time in a long while, if not ever, that we are actually... Did we actually finish the day with 0 failures? This is excellent. We lost nobody. Well, Muradian got hit in the nose, but nothing too serious. Yes! We did took some corruption money, which I'm not too happy about it, but the game forced me. I had no choice in the matter. And we also got quite a nice set of currency here, so we can... Ooh, we can buy a bearded beast. Let's buy him. He's tough. 330. Buy... I think we are also going to buy Goat Horn. I love that name. And yeah, let's take Valentin also. Fuck it. And a taser cartridge. Yeah. We need people. Okay, so for tomorrow, flower pots is still out for a couple of days. We'll take Glimsy, Birch, Aronovich, our new bearded beast. What? Mr. Nash, even as a kid, I wasn't so interested in my toy soldiers' weapons as in their uniforms. The quality of the seams, the color of the buttons, and the weight of the materials. When I got a little older, I started to design and sew clothes. While I was studying at the academy, I made several prototype police uniforms and dreamed that I could wear them in the service if I ever got a chance. All I need to do is get them out of the closet and iron them nicely. You wouldn't mind, right? I don't really like you using any custom gear. So, I don't know. You are not going to do that. Come on, Nash. Who are you to tell me what I can and cannot wear? I'm a free man, you know, and I quit. Oh, fuck. So we just lost the currency there. Yeah. Oh, shit. This game is forcing me to consider corruption. But I am... Actually, how do we... Oh, yeah. We still have some people here. Oh, okay, so we are doing fine. We have some of these not loyal people who are not wearing their hats. But let's just take everyone we can. So maybe we can send someone to do those investigations also. End the day. And of course a cutscene which is going to last for like 25 minutes.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
It It's me.
I'm listening, Lily.
I decided that I wanted to talk about the woman.
What woman?
About the woman with the coins.
Lily, do you realize that you're calling me in the middle of the night?
It was wrong, Jack, what you did. I'm not trying to exaggerate. It's not the worst thing you could... I don't want to compare it with... I want to tell you that I think it was wrong, and I think that you yourself understand that it was wrong. Am I wrong?
Lily, go to sleep.
Jack, I want to... just want to make sure that we're seeing eye to eye on this. That we're on the same team, you know? It's important to me.
For a cop, nothing's more important than a good night's sleep. You can trust me on that.
It seems I'm more like a nanny than a cop.
And I'm all cop.
Okay, so Lily called out our extortion thingy, which is nice, because I didn't want to do it, but the universe just forced my hand. And I think that's kind of like this how this game is going to play out, that Jack is going to do all those things without my acknowledgement. But, yeah, and then there's a strife between Lily and Jack, or something like this. But I'm trying to be honest, I'm trying to play it cool, and see how far it gets us. But for now, I want to thank you all for watching once again, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.